Our scripture this morning comes from the Gospel of Luke, the 14th chapter, verses 1 and then 7 through 14, and I invite you to follow along. On one occasion, when Jesus was going to the house of a leader of the Pharisees to eat a meal on the Sabbath, they were watching him closely. When he noticed how the guests chose the places of honor, he told them a parable. When you are invited by someone to a wedding banquet, do not sit down at the place of honor in case someone more distinguished than you has been invited by your host. And the host who invited both of you may come and say to you, give this person your place. And then in disgrace, you should start to take the lower place. But when you are invited, go and sit down at the lowest place, so that when your host comes, he may say to you, friend, move up higher. Then you will be honored in the presence of all who sit at the table with you. For all who exalt themselves will be humbled, and all those who humble themselves will be exalted. He said also to the one who had invited him, when you give a luncheon or a dinner, do not invite your friends or your brothers and sisters or your relatives or rich neighbors in case they might invite you in return and you would be repaid. But when you give a banquet, invite the poor, the crippled, the lame, and the blind, and you will be blessed because they cannot repay you, for you will be repaid at the resurrection of the righteous. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. We continue in the Gospel of Luke, as I shared earlier in the service, and we pick up where we ended last week. Last week, we heard the good news that through God's kingdom, through God's healing and wholeness, we have been set free. We are no longer burdened down by our worries and fears. God's love and grace has set us free. And then this week, we come to the Gospel of Luke again, and we are told some table manners that we are called to practice within our own lives. This seems like a very odd combination, but when we remember that Luke's theology is based on the acceptance and recognition of others equals by the practice of breaking bread with one another. So in Luke's mind, the good news that we have been set free by God's grace and God's love is lived out by gathering at the table as the body of Christ. Because we are free, because we are forgiven, because we are loved, we are called to break bread with one another, to gather at the table, to be equals, to share God's grace with one another. We are called to practice acceptance. As followers of Jesus Christ, we are called to share God's love. As ones who have known and we've experienced a different way to be in community with one another, we are called to practice good table manners in all things and through all things. And when I say table manners, I'm not talking about those etiquette courses that we were forced to take as children, or those family dinners that we're sitting there with our parents and they're reminding us, don't put your elbows on the table. As I tell my kids all the time, please use a fork and use a napkin to wipe your mouth. These are table manners that we are taught as kingdom people, as beloved community people. They go beyond just being polite with one another. They are the very foundation of our faith, and they remind us all that we have been named and claimed as beloved children of God, that we are called to be in relationship with one another, to live in community with one another. These good table manners that Luke is describing in our text this morning tells us that we as disciples of Christ can come along and enter into the building up of the kingdom of God by practicing good table manners with one another. In our scripture today, Jesus tells this parable. And usually as readers of the gospel, we know that when that phrase, Jesus tells them a parable, it's usually followed up by a phrase like, the kingdom of God is like. and we're used to the kingdom of God is like yeast. The kingdom of God is like a mustard seed. The kingdom of God is like a woman who has lost a coin. So we're waiting for Luke to say, the kingdom is God is like. But Luke never does this in this parable context in our scripture today. And we realize that Luke is shifting the narrative on us once again. He's showing us that parables are not just something we read about. Parables are something that we live out as kingdom people. They become a practice for us. They show us how we are to relate to one another as the people of God. Luke shows us that what starts out as horrible table manners and etiquette for a group turns into a radical transformation, a radical invitation for us as people of faith. In our text today, Jesus reminds the guests to find the seat at the lowest point of the table. And he's not doing this to say, you know, you need to have this false sense of humility so when the host comes to you, you can make a big show of moving up to that higher point. Jesus is reminding us that the kingdom of God does not play by our rules. It does not look for stature and wealth to honor those. The kingdom of God is like grace given that cannot be earned. The kingdom of God does not care about our wealth, our titles, our education, our social status. The kingdom of God is grace. The kingdom of God is like that first time we were accepted for who we are, not for what we could give or do for other people. By taking the lower place at the table, we are showing that as children of God, we have a different understanding of how the world is called to work. And remembering that the grace that was first shared with us, that became a part of us, this grace that we can never repay, this grace that is a gift to us, we are called to share with others. No strings attached. As people of faith, we know we did not earn this grace because of our titles, our degrees, our wealth, our position. We are given the grace of God. We are given the love of God because God claimed us and named us as God's very own. Jesus drives this point home further when he reminds us that the kingdom of God is like a huge banquet filled with all of God's children, not just the people we like. Not just the people that look like us and think like us. The kingdom of God is like a fabulous dinner party that we are surprised that we are invited to. The kingdom of God is like this all-you-can-eat buffet with free drink refills and decadent desserts, and all of God's creation is invited to attend. As Jesus tells us this parable, we are reminded that as children of God, we are called to look at our lives, to look at our relationships through the lens of the kingdom of God. And Luke has been telling us since the beginning of his story that the kingdom of God is where the humble are made low and the low are exalted. Where the first will be last and the last will be first. Where the rich will be made poor and the poor will be rich. Where justice will abound for all of God's people. Luke is reminding us that when we gather at the table, when we come together as the body of Christ, when we represent God here on earth as Jesus' servants, we no longer define ourselves and our self-worth by status, by money and power, or crave those places of honor. We know that we are called to be the beloved community for all of God's people. At the very heart of Jesus' good table manners this morning, he's reminding us that we are called to be gracious hosts, not just for family and friends, but for all of God's children, because we know what it is like to be welcomed by our gracious host, our God who loves us more than we will ever know. Jesus calls us to live out these good table manners, not just by sending a check to take care of the poor, but by inviting them to our table. Jesus calls us to live out these good table manners, not just by speaking about justice in our churches, but going out into the street and being the voice for the voiceless. Jesus calls us to practice these table manners by not just practicing communion on Sunday mornings, because it's what we've always done. Jesus calls us to practice these good table manners by practicing an open table, by welcoming all, by setting no boundaries, by not excluding anybody, and welcoming all to come and join in the feast. We remember that moment when Jesus broke the bread. It was a life-changing moment, life-transforming moment for the disciples and for us as disciples of Christ here today. We remember that when Jesus lifted up the cup and said, "This is the cup of the new covenant, which is poured out for each and every one of you." He was surrounded by those who would betray him, those who would deny him, and all those who would run away. Yet he still welcomed them and embraced them as friends. As disciples of Christ, when we practice good table manners, we reflect the kingdom of God in all that we do and say. And we take to heart what the example that Jesus gave to us, to welcome all, embrace all, to not exclude anyone, to welcome the sick, the lame, the poor, the stranger, the righteous, all to come together. For that is what the kingdom of God is like. That is what good table manners are for. The opportunity to come together, to come to the table and hear those words again. "Welcome, my child, for I have named you and claimed you as my own. Welcome, my beloved, for you are created in the image of God. Welcome, all of my creation, for the kingdom of God is in our midst. Welcome, one and all, and we embrace the light of love that is reflected in each of you. For the kingdom of God is like a gathering of God's people, all coming together, practicing hope, practicing justice, practicing the welcome and grace of God."